This is Bonnie. This is what she looked like when I met her in 2018. She is already 16 years old then. I'll never forget this little quirk of hers. Whenever she wanted love, she'd pat you on the arm as if to say, "Excuse me, it's okay. You can pet me now." I thought that was so cute. This is Bonnie on the day my wife got her, and her brother Clyde. At the time, my wife had no idea that house cats can live as long as 20 years. Sadly, Clyde died at age 10 of a urinary obstruction. Here's Bonnie as an adult, looking healthy and strong. And here she is again as the geriatric cat I fell in love with. As a remote contractor, I was already working from home pre-pandemic. So when my wife would go to work, it was just me and the monster all day. When she wanted lunch, I'd feel her pawing at the backs of my legs. And when I needed a break, I'd give her a massage or some yard time on the patio. In March of 2020, we decided to get a dog. We rescued this frightened chihuahua from a local shelter and named him Peanut. We knew that Bonnie would have to make a big adjustment to life with Peanut. She was curious at first, but whenever Peanut got too close, she'd hiss and tell him to get lost. Unfortunately, Peanut attracted fleas. Not only did we have to give her flea baths and a flea collar, but we eventually had to trim her fur down because spotting the fleas was difficult. As you can see, we did it ourselves and made a mess of it. She was vomiting, having trouble urinating, and was clearly in pain. In the 2 short years that I had known her, she had suffered a number of health issues, each one threatening to end her life. Yet, amazingly, she had pulled through each time with medication. This time would be different. We rushed Bonnie to the vet, where the prognosis was either cancer or kidney failure. Now, this is a decision that any pet owner knows is a difficult and heart-wrenching one, and we didn't make it lightly. But we felt that after 18 years, practically an eternity in cat years, it was time to give her peace and let her go.
I think I just felt her pulse stop.
After Bonnie died, I cried for a solid week. A little less the next week. A little less the following week. And so forth. But I still miss her to this day. After my wife and I got married, we honeymooned for 2 weeks in Southeast Asia, spending most of our time in Bali. The local artisans handcraft these wooden ducks, usually with colorful boots on. We told ourselves that we had to buy one before we left, but we forgot to. About 9 months later, we went to visit my wife's family in New Hampshire. At a local arts and crafts store, we noticed this duck and immediately said to each other, "Let's buy it." Only later, when we got home and took a closer look, we noticed that the tag had a name on it. Bonnie.